Alrighty, I'm just boiling up some water. It's about 8:30. Got the fire going, pretty nice, and just fed the log in some more. Right over there, if you can see them on the ground, right here where my foot is, that's the end of my brush pile. So I'm really hoping that my coal base is good enough to keep this big log going. Probably not. I expect to run out of fire around probably 10 o'clock. I was hoping to go to midnight, but it's not going to happen. I may get up in a couple hours, go track down some more fuel, but probably not. I don't know. We'll just see how it goes, and worst case scenario, I'm only a mile away from my house, so maybe just over a mile, so all I do is just pack up my gear and hike on out. No big deal. And I'll try it again, but one thing's for sure, you can't say I didn't try. The only thing I've used other than what I normally carry on my emergency kit is my bivy sack. Other than that, everything I've used up to this point has only been out of my emergency kit and my normal day hike supplies. And the only reason, again, why I'm using the Army bivy sack is because my saw broke and I wasn't able to collect enough firewood to keep me warm throughout the night. So, I think I said it earlier, but I definitely need to say it one more time. In the winter time, when fire is a necessity in a bushcraft scenario like this, bring something that's not going to break. Bring an axe. You can count on an axe. And or a hatchet, one of the two. Or, sorry, machete. Machete, an axe, or a hatchet. Got to bring one of those. So I do have a small pack axe, and I have a small hatchet. And then I have the machete axe crossover. So one of those three will always come out with me from now on. And in the winter time, in the summertime, I'll be okay with a saw. But yeah, learning experience. One more thing real quick, let me just clean this off real quick so you can watch the fire while I give a couple other suggestions. One other thing is these cheap Mylar blankets. They're great, but I think they're just a little too small. The Adventure Medical Kits Mylar blankets, where they're orange on one side and the Mylar shiny stuff on the other side. Those open up to be way bigger, would be a whole lot easier to make a shelter with one of those, because they're also a whole lot stronger. They weigh just an ounce more, I think, but that ounce gives you, I think 6.5 feet long by like 5 feet wide or something like that. I'd have to look at the measurements for sure, but they're a lot bigger than these smaller Mylar blankets, the off-brand ones. Let's see. And you definitely want twice as much pine boughs on the ground than what I showed you earlier. It's not tremendously cold, and I might be able to make it through the night, but I would be a whole lot warmer had I more. And if I had my axe, I definitely could have gotten me a ton more. I could have a good foot layer thick down here, but another reason to bring an axe. Let's see. I brought about 20 feet of paracord, and I think next time, from now on, I'll bring at least 50 feet. 20 feet where I had enough. I had just enough to do what I wanted to do, but that's just it. I had just enough to do it. So from now on, I'll carry a full 50-foot Hank in my day hike bag. And let's see. Breaking trail in snow that's chest high is a pain in the butt. I'm really, really tired. And I think I'm going to sleep good tonight. If I could just stay warm. So, there's a whole lot of heat coming off. Outside, it's 22 degrees approximately. And under here, it is around 35 degrees. So there is about 13 degrees difference underneath this shelter here. And I got it all set up so the wind's blowing away from it and not into it, which is good. That snowbank back there hasn't started to melt or anything. It's making a really great heat reflector. And looks like my water's starting to boil, so I'm going to cut you off here and take care of that. Alright, everybody. I just show you the temperature gauge real quick. It just blows my mind. Let me get to it. 30, if you can see that, 38.1 underneath my tarp. There's the good old campfire going. I do have to say, if I could keep this fire going all night, I could stay here indefinitely. It's almost 40 degrees under here. And then I crawl inside my bivy sack and I'd be roasting. Man. This has turned out to be one damn good shelter. And I'm really liking it a lot. I'm going to go ahead and when I leave here, because it's so close to my house and I can always come back, and this is one of my favorite spots, I'm going to go ahead and leave this shelter here. And next time I come back, I'll just keep adding to it. I'll probably have to dig out the front section here where the fire is and whatnot. But what I'll do is I'll take all the bedding that's under here. I'm going to take that and I'm going to put it on the top as part of the roof. And then when I come back and have to dig everything back out, I can, I won't be trying to shovel through all the old bedding. And the old bedding will add as sealant for the roof. So all I have to do, we'll have to just shovel this out and then get some more bedding, put it down, get a good set of bedding this time. And then focus on firewood. I will, I think I'm going to spend another night out here. Probably Monday or Tuesday, maybe Wednesday at the latest. If I don't get out here by Tuesday night, then I probably won't do it next week. But I'm going to shoot for Monday night or Tuesday night. And this time bring an axe and really get enough, get a good stack of firewood. And then after I got a really good stack of firewood, then I'm going to work on the bedding, because the bedding is really easy to collect, and I could even do that in the dark with a flashlight. So the firewood's a little bit harder. So, yep. I think I may bring out a saw, but I'm going to bring out a forestry saw, also known as a bow saw. And but I'm not going to bring the bow part. I'm just going to bring the blade. And the first thing I'll do is make the bow for it. And then I'll go and collect the firewood with the axe. And then once I get the big pieces of the big logs like I got tonight, then I'll use the bow saw to chop the logs up. And I think I'll have a much easier time. But that will be an actual camping event. That's not going to be where I'm practicing my emergency shelter skills. That when I come back out, I'm actually going to bring a sleeping bag and some stuff. So, and possibly a tarp, depending on. Well, I'll probably bring out a tarp just in case this shelter has fallen apart, and I'll just have to build another one. So, but alrighty, I'm going to go ahead and call it a night for you guys. I'm going to stay here as long as I can. And if it gets too cold, I'm just going to pack up and go in. But I'm going to stick it out as long as I can. And if I do pack up and go back in, I will turn the camera back on and let you guys know that. In other words, in the morning, I'll turn the camera on, let you see that I'm still here. And break camp and head on out. So, alrighty. Talk to y'all later. Hopefully my battery does well tonight. It's about a half a battery right now, as long as I keep it warm.
Okay. It is, 11 o'clock, 11 p.m., and I kind of ran out of fire and whatnot, so what I did is I figured I could either stay here and tough it out and end up getting up at like 2 o'clock in the morning and being freezing cold and having to try to pack up, or I can call it a night, pack up while I'm warm, and head back in. It all boiled down to not having that saw, which prevented me from having enough fuel for the fire. So I'm going to come out and try this again, only next time I'm going to bring an axe and my forestry saw and see if that makes a difference. But I took all the bedding, if you can see down there, I took all the bedding that was underneath that I was sleeping on, and I went ahead and I tossed it on top of the shelter here. And I put the fire out, and the reasoning for that is when I come back and I dig this out, this should all remain, and there should be some blowing snow that's gone in there that I could shovel right out, and shovel out the snow here where I had the campfire, shovel that out, and then I can stack up a whole bunch of wood and get another campfire going, and then make up a bedding. And this time the bedding will be about 3 times as thick, so I won't have any cold spots, and then the fire will have plenty of wood. So, I'm going to hike through the woods. I'm going to use my